Hi, I'm Luzer Twersky. I'm an actor in the new film, Dovbush, and here's my story. Once upon a time, well, I play my great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather, whose name was Baal Shem Tov, who was the founder of the Hasidic movement. I have a friend who's an actor. He was in a Netflix show called Unorthodox. And he reached out to me and said that there's this role that they wanted him for and that he's not available to do, so he recommended me. And I'm like, okay, cool, what is it? He's like, listen, it's this Ukrainian movie. I don't know if you're interested. I'm like, you had me at Ukrainian, you know? I'm like, it's interesting. It's something I haven't done before. And he told me that it's the Baal Shem Tov. And I said, absolutely, I'll audition for it.
Між собою ворогують. Хтось має за них стати.
Алекса Дош.
Сюди йде велике військо. Військо Потоцького.
Положиш крест нападом і розбоям Довбуша.
But at first they asked me, actually you don't have to do any scene. We just want a tape of you singing the famous Baal Shem Tov song. And I'm like, oh, I can do that. You know, that's something that's gonna stand out from other auditions because I actually know the song. I grew up with the song. It's in my blood. It's in my body. I know how to sing it properly. So I just sent in a tape of me singing the famous Baal Shem Tov songs. I am not a very relaxed person. I am a very stressful, high-strung, anxiety-filled. But I had to play someone, not just calm, but with real inner peace. I think it taught me something about how to tap into that, almost where, like, if I have to be completely calm and relaxed, and I can get there. Especially after shooting in the river, which was extremely cold and uncomfortable. And I had to speak in a foreign language and be calm at the same time while my body wants to shiver. I had to channel the Baal Shem Tov's fearlessness. And it taught me something about myself, that when you believe that you have to do something to prove to yourself that you can do something, you can probably pull it off. When I meet someone who speaks Ukrainian, I was like, oh, you know, I did a Ukrainian movie and I still remember some of my lines. And that's Хто врятував одне життя, врятував весь світ.
Підхід був в тому, що це не просто навчити української мови, не української мови, а саме вивчити діалог для фільму, але передати українську енергію, українську душу. Це було таке головна фокусація. Ну і він почав відрізняти вже, що українська мова дуже емоційна, дуже енергійна, і це не можна порівняти до англійської мови. І що саме ту роль, яку він мусив виконувати в фільмі, йому треба було передавати цю енергію.
The thing is that I have the language in my body. Growing up in Brooklyn, there was a lot of, you know, Russian, Ukrainian, Italian, Polish immigrants, and my parents didn't drive, so we took taxis everywhere. And all the taxi drivers were mostly Russian, Ukrainian, Polish. So I always heard the language in the background. And I picked up words here and there because, for example, I knew that a taxi from Borough Park, which is my neighborhood, to Williamsburg, which is another Hasidic neighborhood, was $15. Well, back then, now it's a lot more. So I would always remember that you get into a taxi and say, 15. And I was like, 15? I was like, and then I learned that 15 is 15. I don't know how to say 1, 2, 3, 4 in Russian, but I know how to say 15, you know? So if you tell me 15, I'm like, I know that number. You know, robot, давай, you know, like, and because I've always been very good with doing imitations of people, you know, doing impressions, I picked up on the sounds and the r and the we near, you know, so like I was able to do that. So that made it a little bit easier for me to learn Ukrainian. They put me in touch with Tamara, and we started. So I already knew a little bit. I was already doing Duolingo as well, you know, learn words and phrases. So I was a little bit, but it was the beginning. I remember it was just, you know, breaking my teeth. She kept saying, oh my God, you're so good, you're so close, you're very good with this, you're so easy, this is, you're picking this up very quickly. And I was like, no, I can't, this doesn't work, it sounds terrible, I can't remember it. You know, it's too difficult, it's the, you know, the consonants just, the kind of like, just mix with each other, and like, the, I don't know what, where the word begin. So what I would do is, she would teach me a line, you know, and then I would take it and kind of like, listen to it, and forget about how it's spelled or how it's written. How does it sound? And then I would transliterate it into English. And sometimes you can look at my script. You know, it's completely incomprehensible to Ukrainians. I showed it to a Ukrainian a couple of nights ago. She could not for the life of her read it. And then when I read it to her, she was like, it sounds perfect. I've been to Ukraine before as a teenager, I guess like 22 years ago I was here. I was here the second time, about 12 years ago, I went to Uman. So it's just interesting that every time I come, like every 10 years or so, just the country is just completely different. I think what surprised me is the fact that I had, my expectations were actually low, which is always, but especially coming to a country that is, you know, developed, but also still developing. I think my expectations was it's going to be like haphazard, ramshackle kind of production values. And after my first day on set, I was like, damn, these guys are good. Like when I sat down in that makeup chair, hair and makeup, and saw what they did to my face, I was like, wow, these guys are really, really good. So the level of just sheer, raw skill that these filmmakers have, and I'm not just talking about the director and the AD and the grips and the makeup and the costume designer, that woman, just pure practical skill, you know, and I'm not just talking about work ethic and being able to dress 300 extras in period clothes, you know, on under the circumstances and the heat and you know, with the budget and everything. I was thoroughly impressed by everything. So but again, that is because of my prejudice, you know? It's because I was like, oh, Ukrainians, let's see what they can do. I'm from Hollywood, you know? Yeah, let's see what they can do. But I was wrong, you know? And I'm glad I was wrong. I would come to Ukraine to shoot this, you know, thing that I've never heard of about, I didn't grow up with Alexa Dovbush here, like every person I tell them, like, oh yeah, we learn about it in school, you know, most actors just wouldn't do this kind of things, and to me, that is one of the most interesting things about what I do, you know, you get to really open your mind and change your perspective on people and history and places and things, and I love that, you know, I love that.